Which of the following values is equal to the value above? And we have the square root of 0.4 times the square root of 1.25. Well, one, we could use an exponent property here, or I guess we could call it a radical property, that if I have the square root of a times the square root of b, that's going to be equal to the square root of a times b. So in this case, a would be 0.4 and b would be 1.25, so this is going to be the same thing as the square root of 0.4 times 1.25. And what is that going to be? Well, let's see, that's going to be, so let's see, 4 times 1.25 would be 5, but this is 0.4 times 1.25, so this is going to be 0.5. So this is going to be the square root of 0.5. And if I look at the choices over here, let's see, this is the fourth root of 0.5, so that's not what it's going to be. This is the square root of 1.65, so that's going to be a different value. This is 0.5, not the square root of 0.5. This is just 1/2, but we want to get the square root of 1/2, so that's not going to be that. So this should be the same thing as the square root of 0.5. Let's see if that's the case. So the square root of 0.5, that's the same thing as the square root of 1/2. 0.5 is 1/2. This is the same thing as the square root of 1 over the square root of 2. Square root of 1 is just 1, so it's 1 over the square root of 2. And then we could do what's often called rationalizing the denominator. A lot of folks don't like dividing by an irrational number, so we can multiply both the numerator and the denominator by the same value, in this case, square root of 2. And then we're going to get 1 times square root of 2 is square root of 2. And then square root of 2 times square root of 2 is going to be 2. So the square root of 0.5 is indeed equal to the square root of 2 over 2. And we are done.